Good morning, everybody. It is Sunday, November 14th. It's about 8 a.m. I have to get ready. We're heading over to do load-in for our gig today at the Telefunken factory, where they have a performing area stage. It's really beautiful setup that they have there. Last night, we got to go over there, and they had an event there. Alan Friedman and all of his friends, they're all accountants and lawyers and stuff, have a band, and it was really fun just to see them all having a good time, and it was really great. Doug Wimbish was there from Living Color, the bassist. I haven't seen Doug since the NAMM show. And Bernard Purdy was there, and got to hang with Bernard, who's like one of the greatest musicians I've ever worked with. And it was really fun, but we're going over early this morning to do load-in, because our gig today is kind of early afternoon. So I'm a little tired today, but be moving by the time I get downstairs. I got an hour to get ready, so I wanted to get a video off to you before I head off to Woik. I'll get right into it. Today I want to go back to the singer who I'd worked with on a number of albums, and I always enjoy her as a person and as a writer. Her career was primarily as a writer, but did have like pretty massive success with a number of songs, but one in particular, and that's Kim Carnes. The album that I want to look at today was St. Vincent's Court, and we cut this in 1979. It was produced by Daniel Moore, Kim herself, and her husband, Dave Ellingson. And it was produced by engineered by Larry Hirsch, and we recorded it at Armin Steiner's studio, Sound Labs, where I've talked about that many times, where we did things like Diana Ross and lots and lots and lots of projects at Armin's studio. It was Catty Corner from Capitol Records building. And Armin is still like one of the greatest engineers of this industry. Sorry, but I was looking back, and Kim's career is incredibly extensive, going back into the early 60s as a writer. And if you're at all curious about her, just Google her up, because it's way too much to talk about right now. But one thing I did notice, I'm going to read off of this, because this led to her really her massive hit. So it says, in 1981, Carnes recorded the Jackie DeShannon and Donna Weiss song Betty Davis Eyes, originally written and composed in 1974. As the first single released from the album Mistaken Identity, it spent 9 weeks at number one on the U.S. singles charts and became a worldwide hit. The song's success propelled the album to number one on the Billboard 200 for 4 weeks. The single became the biggest hit of the entire year for 1981 and is second only to Olivia Newton-John's Physical as the biggest hit of the 1980s in the U.S., according to Billboard. The song earned both Record of the Year, Song of the Year awards at the 82 Grammys. Carnes was nominated for Best Pop Female Vocal for Mistaken Identity, and also earned a nomination for the Album of the Year. The two follow-up singles were released from the album, the title track and Draw the Cards, which also charted in the United Kingdom and Australia. Carnes and her band rehearsed Betty Davis Eyes in the studio for 3 days to take the melody and overall sound to the record to a darker, more haunting place. Keyboard player Bill Cuomo came up with the signature instrumental lick, and together with the band and producer Val Garay created a completely new arrangement for the song, recorded the next day with no overdubs. And this is where I thought it got kind of cool too. Betty Davis admitted to being a huge fan of the song and approached Carnes and the songwriters to thank them. Davis wrote Carnes after the song was released, saying that she loved the song. It was a thrill to become part of the rock generation. She said in her memoir, This and That. Davis's grandson, Ashley, told Screen Legend, had finally made it. This is great. Carnes and Davis struck up a special friendship, and with the singer visiting her at her home several times before Davis's death in 1989, in which she considers a career highlight, Carnes performed the song live for Davis at a tribute to the legendary actress held just before her death. More recently, the song was used in the 2008 Clairol Nice and Easy TV commercials in the United Kingdom and in an ad featuring the song expanded into South Africa and other territories around the world. In 2008, the song was featured in the opening scene of the documentary film Valentino, The Last Emperor, and continues to be licensed for film and TV use. In November 2015, the song was the set piece for the backstory of Liz Taylor in the TV anthology American Horror Story Hotel. And it goes on and on. I mean, that's just off of that one song, but she has so many songs that she's done for artists from James Ingram to Kenny Rogers. I mean, it's like a who's who of the business when you start looking at all of the people that Kim has been attached to during her career and still is, because she's still at it as an avid, you know, powerful songwriter and artist. So I've done, like, I think three albums with her. I was involved in at least three albums. But I'm going to go ahead and just play a couple of songs, and then I've got to get off to work. And I just figured she would be a nice taste for a Sunday here, and a nice way to kick off getting into my musical adventures today. So the first song I'm going to play is called Goodnight Moon, and it's myself and Matt Betton on drums, Bill Cuomo on keyboards, Dave Ellingston, her husband, on guitar, and Daryl Leonard on trumpet. And the background vocals on this are Danny Tim, Stan McElroy, Brian Cadd, and Dave Ellingston. So here we go. This is Kim Carnes from her St. Vincent's Court album.
Thank you.
That was written by Kim and her husband, Dave Ellingson. So that's a little information. Next song I want to do is Paris Without You. And this, again, is myself and Matt Betton on drums, Bill Cuomo, Bobby Cochran on guitar, Tim Weisberg on flute, Bobby Hall on percussion, and Jerry Peterson on sax, and Bill also, Cuomo also playing the arp string ensemble during this. A standard of the day for string parts. So here we go, Paris Without You.
Christmas in a parlor car with no one else.
just a nice Sunday cruise. I've got one last song here. This is called Looking for a Big Night. And this is myself on bass, Matt Betton on drums, Bill Cuomo on keys, Bobby Cochran on guitar. In the background vocals on this are Danny Timms, Stan McElroy, Dave Ellingson, and Daniel Moore. So here we go, one last little tune here. Oh, come on, start at the top where it's supposed to be. Come on. That's it for Sunday. Have a, just a wonderful day. I really, Kim is so unique. Boy, the minute she opens her mouth, sings like one note, you go, oh, Kim Carnes, yeah. But check out her discography and her history on Google. She's really amazing. I mean, she's had a really long career since she was a kid. really amazing. And I always find it fascinating when I start studying up on these artists and realize, like, even before I knew it, how many times we were connected through different people in the community itself, because it's such an amazing community. So so just to have a great day, I'm going to get ready and head over, and we'll unload our Sprinter van, get our gear out there, set up, and play. I think it's going to be fun today. We do a shorter set today, but there's also a Q&A period, which will be a lot of fun. I love when the audience asks questions and we get to talk to them. So that should be a lot of fun. And we're off and running, so they say, whoever they are. So again, I am going to put out a thank you to the people, especially who don't get a weekend, are working their souls off, just trying to maintain some well-being for people that are in terrible situations, some of which I know at this moment who are really suffering and going through some bad times. So my heart's with all those healthcare workers and everybody else who's doing so much work every day trying to keep this all working. You know, it's a tough one. So have a great rest of your weekend. Yeah, I'll be back tomorrow. Try to get something off before we jump in the van and head out of town, wherever the hell we're going next. That's one thing I never know. People say, oh, where are you going? I say, I don't know. You know, just somebody will let me know what time I have to be downstairs in the morning. And that's all that really matters. So, but I'm looking forward to seeing some friends. I know that Doug Wimbish said he was going to be back today for the show, and hopefully Bernard will be there. It'd be fun to play for them. It's always fun to look out and see your friends in the audience. So have a great one. I'm going to get running, and that's it. Just have a great one. Bye-bye.